Hi everyone, this is Nick. Today I'm gonna go through two different ways that you can test your thumbnail images out in PowerPoint for the most effective version. So the first thing you need to do is actually create those thumbnail images. And we have videos about how to create thumbnail images in PowerPoint. This is my PowerPoint deck right here. I'm gonna make this video here about how to A/B test your thumbnail images. And these are the three different images that I'm going to be testing out here. We have the exact same imagery on all the slides, but there are different colors. So we have this blue, red, and yellow test. That we're going to try. The first thing I want to do in PowerPoint, once I create these slides, these are just normal slides, 16:9 orientation, have my picture on them, some images, the YouTube logo, and also some text. And I'm just gonna export these as images. So what I'm gonna do to make this super easy is I'm gonna highlight these three. I'm gonna use my BrightSlide free PowerPoint add-in, and I'm going to go to the export tab and export these slides as images. I just want them to be the same size, and I'm gonna put them as JPG files, JPEG files, because YouTube doesn't like when files are too big, when the thumbnail files are too big. So you wanna make sure that they're JPEGs because those are a bit smaller size. So we're gonna go click okay. I'm gonna go and point these to my desktop. It's gonna save these three out as images, and it's gonna tell me we've saved those three slides. Awesome. Now what we're gonna do is we are going to go over to our YouTube channel right here. I wanted to show you the first way that we're gonna use to test these is to create an image poll on the community tab. Now everybody on YouTube, even if you have one subscriber or zero subscribers, has access now to the community tab. So I recommend that you start posting there just like any other social media form, but you can create a poll. Here's one poll that I created asking for opinions on two different thumbnail options. I had 27 votes, and the one with the person in it turned out to be the winner. But I wanted to show you how you can get to that community tab. So go over to your channel, click on the community tab, and here you can create a post, and these are all the different posts that you can make here right along the bottom. I'm gonna go ahead and say image poll, and I'm just gonna say, which thumbnail image do you like the best? And we're gonna go ahead and click on, navigate to the photos. Oh, there they are right there. We're gonna have the blue one right there, and you can type in some text. We will put the red one here, open, there we go. Red, add option. And let's go a click yellow for number three. Awesome, and now I'm gonna post this. Click on post right here. And we will just wait for those votes to sort of roll in. You will be able to see those if that is your community tab. So that's the way, number one, that you can start thumbnail testing or testing out your thumbnail images. Now the other way is to use YouTube's test and compare feature. So if we go into a video, this is the editing view of one of the videos that I just uploaded about how to make subtitles for your YouTube videos. Scroll down right here underneath the thumbnail. This is where you upload your thumbnail image. Now normally you can upload your own custom thumbnail image, but if you click on the ellipses right here, this options button, you can see that we have this option that says test and compare. This is a new feature that was recently rolled out from YouTube. Here you can test and compare three different options for your thumbnails. Now I'm not gonna upload the A/B testing thumbnails that I just did because this is a different video, but once I create this video that I'm talking on right now, I'm gonna upload it. I'm gonna upload those three A/B test thumbnail images that I put up there, and we'll see which one wins, the red, blue, or yellow. When you're finished with this, you can click on done. And I wanna show you, if we go over to one of the videos that I'm currently testing right here, this one that I just posted the other day, it doesn't have much data. So you can go here, once you have the test and compare feature enabled, you can say view test report, click on that, and it will show you the data that it has. Now this one doesn't have any data. It will test out the thumbnail image for 14 days, and the one that has the most watch hours behind it through the people who click in it when they see your feed, that is gonna be the one that's the winner, and YouTube will automatically choose that one. Now you can always go back and change it yourself. You can customize it yourself if you want to, but after that 14-day window, YouTube is going to change it for you. So pretty cool way. We have two different ways to test out thumbnail images for your YouTube videos. I hope you give it a try. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word, sometimes these YouTube tips and tricks. I can't wait to see you all next time.